Hello friends, welcome. My name is Sarveshwar. In this video, we would learn how to generate an object in R. Friends, R is an object-oriented language. So whenever we want to do anything in R, like making a formula or any kind of function we write in R, it is executed on some objects. So R has some objects. So first, just to imagine what is an object. So for that purpose, you can imagine like an Excel sheet we perform on some function in MS Excel. So where we have some cells in an Excel sheet, that is also an object. The sheet, the entire sheet is also an object. And this file of Excel that contains many sheets, that is also an object. This is a simple thing we can understand so far in terms of object. So here, if we come here, how to generate such kind of objects in R. Okay friends, so here we generate objects using the assignment operator, which is having the sign either less than equals or equal sign. I generally use equal sign because it is much easier for me, because I am putting something equal something. So it's up to you. Suppose I say x, assign the value of 5 by using the control enter command here. One more thing friend, this is the window I had already mentioned in my previous video. This is the window where we write R scripts, so they can be saved for future use. These all scripts I am writing here would be available on my website, so you can download it and reproduce whatever I am doing here. Exactly. And when we execute some window, like suppose I am on this like command X N, and when I go on run, I go on run and I click OK. It is executed in this console window. Okay friends, here we write the commands, so we can use them in further again and again. And after selecting them, when we run, so it is execution that happens in console. You don't need to select the entire line. You can click anywhere on this line, like here, here or here, and just click run. This entire line will be executed in console. So here the value is generated. This is the environment of R here. Here this is the environment. So we write the commands here. Those are executed in console and the objects are saved in the environment here in this third window. And after executing all the commands, when we save the output for future use, this output would be go in files here. Okay friends, in this way, these all four windows are useful. And we can also use the equals command for assignment. Y equals 5. If I click on that, I go there and run, it's y is equal to 5. Okay friends, so I will be using equal sign for assignment across the videos I'll be using for this course series. Okay friend, and suppose we want to assign some calculation to this object X. Suppose I want to assign 5 into 6 plus 2. I want to assign 5 into 6, 30 plus 2, this is 32. I want to assign this value to X object. So this is the command. I would simply use X equals 5 into 6 plus 2. And I will just go on this line. And one more thing friend, the hashtag here. Hash is a character we use here for commenting. R ignores whatever we write to the right side of the hashtag or sharp sign, we can say here. So when we write hash and then write anything after that, it would be ignored by R. So I write hash. And then R is a dynamic language. Dynamic means whenever we assign some value to an object, the old value of that object would be lost. Earlier we had assigned X equals 5 here. Now suppose I assign this new value. I select this line and use run command. Now the X value has changed to 32. And suppose again I do some more calculation and I assign X equals 6 plus 5 and I use run command. I'm on this line and click run. Now it's 11. Now it has changed to 11. So this is a dynamic language which changes the value for every new assignment to a object. Okay friends, I'm clear. R is a dynamic language. So it replaces the old values of the objects with the new one. So this is the way, friends, we generate objects in R. We can generate different types of objects, structures in R, like vector, matrix, data frame, list. It depends upon your needs. What do you want to generate actually? All these structures would be discussed in upcoming videos. Thanks, friends. Keep watching.